Families of Light. This is Iona, and you can find me at www.ionablissfullife7.com. So I tried to record a video earlier for us light leaders, and there was no sound. So I'm going to start take two. So I'm starting over again. So I just wanted to kind of send a message to people who are noticing the different energies on Gaia. A lot of us who are awake. Healers, light workers, shamans, crystal kids, rainbows. I'm an indigo. And we're here to make a difference, you guys. We're here to shine our lights, to not be scared, to come forward as light leaders. There's a lot of help that we can assist the collective, humanity, mankind. And by us shining our lights and not dimming them, we are helping the collective move from fear to love consciousness, to unity consciousness. So I was made different for a reason, and when I was younger, I used to hide my light because I wanted to fit in, and I'm noticing that within the collective is that a lot of women or men, you know, or comparison, there's like that kind of like competition, jealousy, envy, all that kind of stuff. And so for me, I know that I'm made different for a reason, and I'm going to shine my light. I'm not going to hide my voice. I'm not going to be scared or fearful. I'm going to come out and be who I am. So my soul tribe will find me and my star tribe will find me. So I'm talking to star seeds. I'm talking to shamans, ancients walking the earth. I'm talking to old souls. I'm talking to people who, if you're drawn to this channel, if you're drawn to me and, you know, you're wanting to come out of your bubble pretty much, right? When you kind of let go of the ego and the mind space, that's what's happening right now, you guys, in the collective, is our ego and our mind space is starting to diminish. The matrix is crumbling and we're creating this new heaven on earth. We're creating compassionate in action. We are creating as masters, light leaders, almost like ascended masters walking the earth, because we're eternal beings. I'm not this body. I am Iona, but I am this energy who, from all lives of me, because we're multidimensional, is I'm here on earth making a difference because I'm holding my light space. I'm connecting in with the grid. I'm connecting in with the consciousness. I'm being of service to others. I'm helping others who are awakening. Sometimes it seems like you're having a mental breakdown or a crisis. A lot of high intensity energies are coming in. A lot of chaos is happening. But that's why we're here as light leaders, to ground and hold the energy of Gaia. We're here to spread love consciousness, not fear. We're here to help the children. We're here to help the elderly. We're here to help Gaia. So a lot of times when there's a lot of light, a lot of darkness tries to set in to scare you out of, you know, why you're here. And I'm not going to let that deter me from being who I am. I know I'm a powerful being having this human experience. I know that I had to heal through my communication issues. I had a lot of struggles growing up. I was scared of who I was. I was scared to come into my light, my power. I used to believe the programs and what people used to tell me, and I was scared to communicate who I am. But once I healed myself and realized I am a born communicator, I had to step into the higher aspect of me, because there's multiple realities happening. The old reality of Iona was I was scared, I was weak, I went through divorce, I didn't know who I was, because I was trying to people please, and I wasn't who I'm made here to be, who God, this higher power, this universal energy created me to be. So once I started to learn who I am and channel with my higher self and my God consciousness, the cosmos, and my star families of light, I didn't feel weird anymore. I wasn't scared to show who I was, because the right beings are going to come to me. The right soul family, soul tribe, star tribe. You guys know who I am. You're going to be attracted to my energy. It's either you're going to retract from my energy or you're going to be attracted to it. And that's okay. It's all perception of where we're at in our spirituality, where we're at with our awareness. So I'm not going to be offended if someone doesn't agree with what I'm saying or whatever, because we all have different perceptions. We all see through a different lens. And the energies coming through my voice is a sound healing that's coming. So just feel the frequencies coming in, saying yes, that I can work with your higher self, and just allow. Feel the energy of the compassion. Feel the energy of calmness and serenity and balance. As you're connecting in with acceptance, love, trust, growth, your soul evolving, being present in this moment with me, families of light, that you're loved, you're holy, you're at peace, that when you drop into your heart space, drop into your high heart, drop into the center of your chest, close your eyes, feel the presence of God, God, Goddess, inside. Nothing's outside of you, it's inside of you. You've got to unlearn everything that you learned in school to realize this consciousness, this love frequency is you. This higher energy is your spiritual self moving into your body consciousness, realizing that when you stop playing the tapes in your head that are belief systems that don't serve you, you were taught to feel like you're weak, that you're not good enough. I mean, think about it. Isn't that a form of control and fear? If you actually knew how powerful you were, how can they control you? This is you stepping into your passion, your purpose, why you chose to come here at the greatest time of awakening, to remember who you are as an ancient walking the earth. You're not this body, you're not this mind, you're not this ego. Separate yourself from that and realize that you are God consciousness having a human experience through this vessel, which is your body. That's why you are on earth having this human experience. You're going to create whatever you want in your reality, but if you don't believe it, it's not going to come forward. The law of attraction, the universe, it vibrates at a certain frequency, and whatever you want that you put in your vortex is there. And if you believe that you cannot have it, and if you believe that you cannot have it, you won't, because your belief system is strong. But if you can believe that you deserve this and you are deserving of having it, which everyone's deserving of having it, I'm not any more special than anyone else walking the earth. It's just I come into alignment with who I chose to be at this time, in this greatest time of awakening. And I realize, hey, I still have stuff to work on. I'm having this human experience just like you are, but I know I'm a light leader. I've had visions of who I am, what I'm here to do. And if you believe in what you're here to do, and it's like this God consciousness that's working through you is showing you the way. And when you're in tune with who you are as this light being, the higher energies can work through your vessel. When I go into my mind space, my ego, then I freak out because I still have those experiences. That's when I ground, I meditate, and I realize all is well. I have enough. I have what I need. I'm here to be of service. And I know why I'm here. When I was married, when I was, you know, having everything that I thought would make me happy with my children and my house and all these things, those things don't matter. I wasn't happy. I dreaded coming into my house. I didn't want to be there. I didn't want to live anymore because I didn't know who I was, because I was listening to all the outside voices that were telling me who Iona is. No one knows who I am but me, but my higher power, my energy, my love, my light. And once I realized that I love who I am and I'm here to make a difference, that I'm a piece of this whole, that I have these God-given gifts to share, that there's no one light there out me like me. And I need to find out what my gifts are and use them to be of service to help the collective. So I'm over here helping other women and men and children and elderly, like all people, animals, plants, nature, Gaia, everything. It's everything's connected. I'm over here helping and being of service and spreading my compassion, my life lessons, and helping others who connect with me, realizing that they are here for a reason too. And you help lead people, but they also do the inner work, the shadow work. They do the inner work to get to the core aspects of what their belief system are, what their belief systems are, what's holding them back. And once you start to shift that energy within you, you can have anything that's in your vortex. You can have anything that you dream of. You just gotta feel it. The universe doesn't know the difference between reality and what you're imagining. We forget that we're creative beings having a human experience. And when you can tap into your inner child and tap into who you were as a kid, you know, the thing is, what's so great about me is that I've never forgot. And I think part of that aspect is me being an identical twin with my sister. We played these games, we played in other realities. We didn't know what we were, that it was different than what we were doing, because we've always done it. So it's like, I always had these gifts. And now I'm doing it as a profession. And it's what I love to do, because I get to play all day with my clients. I get to teach them just to be a child again. I mean, how awesome is that? You get to play, you get to have fun. You know, I'm a spiritual teacher. I teach classes. I help others with meditations. I channel in healing meditations and I do sessions and clear their blocks. And I help them realize who they've always been underneath all that baggage that's not even real. That fear is not even real. Those old belief systems aren't even real. Your ego is trying to still fight this battle, but since the matrix is collapsing and all these higher energies are coming in from our star families of light, I'm talking to the star seeds. I'm talking to the children who are awake. I'm talking to the collective. I'm talking to the wise people, the ancients. You know who you are. When it resonates with you, you feel it in your body. You're getting chills through your body. You're resonating with the frequency that I am saying as a sound healer. Even though I'm speaking English right now, the tones that are coming through my voice as I'm drawing these frequencies to you, you're going to hear it. Your higher self hears it, but it's more of a feeling. It's more of a toning through my voice, through my eyes. So I want you to look into my eyes, connect in with my soul signature and your soul signature as I'm starting to activate you. You know who you are. Feel the energy of God coming through my eyes, the cosmos, immense love, star families of light, the galactics, Akasha, the Elohim, Kuan Yin, Jesus, Mary Magdalene. Feel the energies coming in. Allow, surrender, trust, and just let it flow in. Feel the peace, the calmness, the healing taking place. Your ancestors, the archangels, Gaia energies below your feet coming up through your portals. The solar disks, the great central sun, universal wisdom, the dolphin energy, the dragons, the star energy, who you are as a star being, having a human experience, activating that within your Akash, opening up, open, awaken, breathe. High frequencies are coming in. Allow. Surrender. Feel the emotions that are coming up because you're remembering who you are, why you're here. To spread love, to spread light, to awaken the other masses on Gaia. To move to the higher dimensional energies, to the fifth and beyond, to higher frequencies where these higher beings of light resonate. Your guides, your ancestors, your guardian angel. We all have a guardian angel. Feel, sense, notice, trust, surrender, allow, just let go and move into your heart that all is well, that these beings are happy, that you are being here in the sacred space, your sacred temple, your holy vessel. You are remembering who you are to help the collective hold that light. And just follow your inner guidance system, your inner light. Listen to your body, your heart, your passions, your dreams, your desires. And just thanking the collective, thanking all of you who are watching this channel. I am so happy that you're here. I'm so happy that you are ready to receive. That you're going to be directed to come here because you're going to know, please like and subscribe to my channel. And I'm just going to start sending this out and start really working with the star seeds and of healers and light workers and the ancients walking the earth, us as ascended masters walking the earth. You're going to know how to find me. And if you like this video and you feel like it would benefit your friends or anyone, share it on your Facebook page. Share it with your friends. The more that we come together, the more that we support one another, we're going to help the collective a lot faster by sharing because there's more than enough to go around that we are supported. And I know that my star tribe and my friends are going to come find me and that we are supported on our mission. And I'm excited that you found me. I love you. Thank you, Star Tribe. Namaste.